Hey guys, Mitsu here. Welcome back to Aether Raids. It is day 4 of Light Season, and yeah, I can just show you how the defenses have worked. Oh, I just got in a failure. Oh well, one foe defeated, but otherwise I got another success yesterday. It's been surprisingly good. I was expecting to have mainly losses, so positive surprise. Not too bothered by one loss, honestly. I mean, just 20 lift loss is good, and it's a free... what's it called? It's a free rematch if I end up trying for it, but you know, it's fine. We haven't lost any ladders yet. We have gotten all pots. Everything is going well. Today is a singles match. Let us get into it and hope that it is, for once, one with a bonus structure and everything. It's a flyer ball. Interesting. Now, here's a bit of a problem, though. Can't I just smite in a Fallen Leon? Because I think I can. Now that is a... Wow, that is a fast Camilla. Jesus. Yeah, they can all move there due to Flyer's guidance and all of that stuff. And yeah, whatever. I'll probably move in turn 2, not too bothered by... I mean, I'll just not put any physical buffs on him, and I do think he should be able to take... I should give him Triangle Adept, honestly. This would make this match a lot easier. But yeah, I'll go turn 2, they'll move down, they'll get hit by the Bull Tower, and from there on out I can clean out with the rest of my units. And that should be fine, I think. Air could probably take out most of them, if I'm being completely honest, after these all get taken out, I hope. I do hope they all get taken out, but they should at least be somewhat damaged, I guess. No. It seems like a plan. Plus 4, interesting. Plus 6, wait, Blar Blade. Oh! Oh, that, thank God I checked. So her effective attack is actually plus 30, I think, right? Because she's getting 6 to all stats. So 76 attack, and next she's going to have, wow, that is a lot. So 76 plus this is going to be 81? But then she's getting the color disadvantage. Where did I put my calculator? There it is. So, in effect, right, weapon triangle disadvantage means you have to do times 0.8. So let's say she has 81. I hope I have calculated everything right, but I do think it is right. So she has 81 times 0.8 is rounded up, so 65. Onto Leon's, where is he? Here he is. Onto Leon's what? 36, right? Yeah, so he has 36. And so that means it's a difference of, I think, 29, I believe? Should be right, right? 36, yeah, it's 29. And he will... half that, so I think it'll be 15. And he has 50 HP, and she won't proc anything. Will we take her out? Probably. Will somebody who follows up take us out? Potentially? And this is one of those that just makes me ask, why not what? Do I go Durdra and take her out? Oh, can I even do that? Then again, I could be... Could I... How fast is she going to be? I mean, she's not getting any sort of... This is a hone, right? So she's not getting any sort of extra thing. Could Shirena, like, the reason I'm thinking Shirena, just to be clear, is because I can put Lucina there and support her, right? and she's going to have enough HP to avoid the panic miner. I can buff her up too. And her speed is going to be, she's getting +4, +4, that is 41. And if I then have Lucina nearby, that's another, I think, +6, if I'm not mistaken. And if I then have another, if I have Peony, that is another +6. And then effectively we're talking, +6, +6, +12, 50 something, right? Yeah, so she won't get doubled at least. And I don't think she'll take a lot of damage. Ruptured Sky. I mean, it's an interesting flyer ball. This Korn is probably the biggest threat. If I'm being honest. Beyond that, I don't really see much of a threat anywhere. And the thing that's unusual about this flyer ball is that the ward flyers are quite spread out, I'd say. I mean, they hit a few units. They mostly protect the middle, the frontliner, because then you have three stacking here onto Katria, so she effectively gets +12 to her defenses, which does make her quite bulky. It's a shame I don't have my Leon, and by Leon I mean L-E-O-N, because I do have a Leon with close counter advantage, and a, what is that, that spooky bow, the one that gives him fury. He would clean out most of this team. Who has the, Korn has the hardy bearing, okay. Oh yeah, Korn can probably take out Ike, can't she? I mean, she does 65. Ike is going to have a lot of defense and attack and everything. I mean, he could probably just take her out on retaliation, can't he? Like, immediately on retaliation. I'd be surprised if that wasn't the case. And then the question is, how much damage does he get from the rest? I mean, it's a 65. Let me just calc out Ike's encounter. So, his res is going to be 30, 34, if Peony, next time at the start, we're talking 34, what would it then be, 30, 41, and then further buffs by Lucina means another +4, +3, +4, so another 7, so like 50 something. Ideally, and even then, otherwise it's around 40-something. And his attack, how much is she going to be stacking? 2 wards, right? So, and she's going to have 30, so it's 48. Sorry, 38 defense. So she effectively has 78 bulk, right? Physical bulk. That's what I have to do in one... right? Again, she gets +6 from the fortify. She gets another +8 from the wards. That means she has 38 defense, effectively in combat. And at the same time, she has 48 HP, which means she has a total then bulk of 86, I believe. It should be, yeah, 86. And I have to do that in one shot in order to kill her. Now, can I do that? I highly doubt it. Oops, that was not what I intended to do. Yeah, I mean, 86 in one shot. Can we do that? I really doubt it. I mean, we're going to have... Do we have a chill attack somewhere? Chill attack... Nope, there is no chill attack anywhere. Okay, so that is no worry at the very least. I will have to take out the panic manner, though. Otherwise, I am going to be debuffed. Okay, Yeah, this one might be tricky. But I said 86 is what we have to do. Ike is going to be getting plus... plus 3 from Lucina, plus another 1 from her support, plus 3 from Peony. So let's say like a minimum of another like plus 7, and 68 times 1.2. Oh, damn it. That is not what I intended to do. 68 times 1.2. 82, or 81 rather. Yeah, no, and we're not going to be... Are we going to be fast enough to avoid the double from her? I don't... Are we? Wait a sec. How much is our speed going to be? Are we going to be in the 50s? We might actually be in the 50s, I think. Right? Yeah, see, no goad. So Ike would probably be in the 50s with everything because he's getting 37, then Lucina gives him another plus 6, and we're talking 43, and then we're talking this, and then that is 47, and then we're talking Peony, and then we're talking 50. So he won't get doubled. Oh wait, he will. 51, yeah, no, that is not, I don't think Ike is an option here. I really don't think Ike is an option here. Can we double Camilla, though? I mean, there is no... What's it called? There is no... What's the name? Bright Shrine. So... Merida will have... How much speed? 48... If... In the right direction, so cardinal direction of Peony. She'll have, oh wait, she's getting even more. Right, she's getting 4, so she's getting 52, and then she's getting 51. And... Ah! Yeah, we're not going to be fast enough to double Camilla. Because she's also in the cardinal direction of Peony. And that means that she has an effective speed of 50. 54. Wow, that is a fast Camilla. Alright, so like even with a Peony speed buff, we would not be fast enough. This is an interesting team, actually. This is a very interesting team. And I'm more and more going back to the idea that Fallen Leon is the right choice here, interestingly enough. I'll do a quick break, and I will be right back. See you soon. Hey guys, I'm back. So, I haven't calculated it in total, so like in full, but I do think it would work. So my idea is that the main thing that is troubling me regarding using Fallen Leon is the healing tower that would prevent my bolt tower from doing as much damage to two of the most threatening units on this team. That I would want to do, and especially this one here. This Corrin does worry me. If I can't take her out with the first hit, she really does concern me. And I think I can do that if I just take out this healing tower. Now, the healing tower is somewhat protected, so there is one way to avoid it. And that is the following. I will go in with air, right? I can move in here, take that out. Then I can... dance with Peony. I can repo out with... Right? Yeah, because when I dance with Peony, she gets the movement buff, so she can warp next to two space of somebody. I can repo Peony out with Marth. Then I can move air over here. Then she's already halfway there to this spot here in order to then smite Leon up. And I will be there after turn 3. And then hopefully have enough time. I can probably clean up over here a bit with young Marth. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get that pot. That pot there is very meanly placed. But I think that is my plan for this match. I am not quite sure how it's going to turn out time-wise, but we will see. I mean, bad comes worse. I have a second repo unit in Shirena. And so I hope it works out. Let's see how it goes. Best way to get the units in place is probably... Would I mind getting hit by? Probably not. I can already clear on this side. I'll just use Shirena in order to use the recoil blaze.
The glimmer of life. Ready? Yes. Let's go.
Now, here's something that this guy would probably should change, in my opinion. Is, oh, this is an interesting dark shrine here. Maybe a tactics room here would help him instead, because then I have to waste one more turn because my peony, my air can't be used here if there was a tactics room. But
tear them to shreds.
I do hope that would still work. We'll see how it works out,
careful.
I guess.
Keep up.
Morning. Yes, the glimmer of life.
And I'm gone, as you can see.
This way?
Now this reaches until there, and so the way I will do this, in order to get him up there, how do I do that best? Because I don't want him to be hit by the,
Tear them to shreds.
My
Who's
turn.
Actually soaking the debuff? Oh, it's Young Marth. That's actually even better. So I don't want him to be hit by, the Bull Tower. That would be very unfortunate. So probably the best way to do that is, Can I even get him up there is the question. Probably can, but how?
Keep up.
Oh, I think I know a way. Should work, right? If I have Shirena there, she can then repo Marth back out, I think? And then I can just smite with air from the spot that I intend.
Yes,
I will go.
Yes, maybe this way.
Yep, that works.
This way?
Yes. The glimmer of life.
And we don't want buffs, and I hope I have... The short time I did calc was enough. I do hope it is enough. I think he should be fine, and then it's a matter of, you know, being fast enough to clear out the rest. Oh no. Why is he so useless? How is he so useless? I seriously do not understand how Leon is so useless. He is such a useless unit. Like, not even... I'm definitely giving him Triangle of Death. He's such a... Oh, God. He is such a bad unit. It's incredible. Like, you would think, like, come on, damaged? And even then, he can't do anything? Really? Ugh. Single. Okay, come on. Oh, it's a plus death gram. But they're locked in. And... Oh, what? Attack death for Mizura. Okay, then. Interesting. We have a plus 10, of course, we have another plus... A plus 1 parry. What does she do again? Mm-hmm.
agility, total speed. Yeah, whatever. Couldn't Marth, young Marth, just vantage the whole map, basically? I mean, I get the feeling that if I put young Marth in here turn 3 to take out Bram, the rest can't do enough to him. I think. Faye might be an issue, I guess. But if I take out the healing tower, she'll have a lot of damage done to her. Perry might do a bit. Sothis has quite a bit of... Like, even then, that should be enough, shouldn't it? So as long as I, like, have another unit here and take out the healing tower... Can I even get there turn 3, though? Probably can. No, but it is a risk, because then this can be broken, and Bram can reach there, and yeah, that's a risky one. It's a very odd setup, though. I would not recommend you do this, because locking in your units like this is a liability, honestly. Who has a hardy bearing, anyhow? Nobody? Because if that's so, I'll just... Like, maybe it's a dumb idea, but... Is it a dumb idea to just put Ike in there? Is it? I'm not so sure, actually. I think he's just gonna rally Elliewood. Yeah, Elliewood should just rally, honestly. Because he can't attack. If I put Ike there, he can't attack. He will rally. Azura will attack. She won't dance. And so I will be safe. And the others just don't do anything to Ike's, and I know that. So, yeah, seems like a plan, at least. Or what's the alternative? I guess the alternative is... Can I even get Dirt in there? Without... I guess I can. I can put her here and just let her attack Bram there from turn... What is that? Turn... Right, 1 attack, 2 attacks here, take out Bram. She should do enough with 35. I mean, all that's left if she does... If the Bull Tower does 35 damage is 9 HP. So, all things considered. He's going to have res plus 5 and... My attack is minus 3, right? So, so my attack is going to be 54, and his res is going to be 41. Oh, 45. All right. Am I just exactly doing enough? So I have to put Peony there, probably, in order to buff her up. Or, like, here, I guess. I can put her there. That's probably better. Because then I can move around with some others, I suppose. Though this tactics room will be a pain. Probably best to move from the side in order to get there. And, yeah. But that does seem like a plan. I can put Shirena there, I can then attack that, then I'm pretty much in position. I can use Loot and Dirt to attack here and take those out. And then I can repo in Dirt, then I can attack him on turn 3. And she will be there, and the rest of the units, I can probably take them out. Sylthus I can take out with Loot, Elliewood I can take out with Loot, or with Shirena, and yeah. And that way I've got all pots. And that seems like a plan. That does seem like a plan. I like that a lot more, because I am using ranged units to take out a boxed-in team, which is really what I prefer to do when teams are boxed-in. Generally, like, this is semi-good just because, with these boxed-in setups, you can sort of let your units out because of the breakable structures, but even then, I don't recommend boxing in your units for reasons like this. It, generally speaking, hinders you more than it helps. And yeah, I think that's something you will see here.
Let's begin. Yes? My turn. Good morning. Let's go. Death's caress. Yes. Ready. Yes. The glimmer of life. Death's caress.
Yeah, I won't go on the trap because if it is the gravity trap, I think it would hit Durger. Or is it in two spaces? And regardless, I don't want to risk it.
Yes.
Yep, he gets it. Here comes Durger. She takes out Bram, no problem. And the only one who can attack now is...
Yes.
There.
Let's go!
We can even take out Elliewood if we want. Do we? I don't think we will. And again. Yeah, no, I'll wait. I'll wait with Elliewood.
The glimmer of life. Maybe death's caress. My turn.
Now we can start baiting them here. Because...
I'll go with you.
Oh, wait.
Yes?
I probably should get out of the way. Because... Yeah, I should get out of the way. How far can she move? One,
what should
two,
I do?
Three. Yeah, like this should be fine.
You need
to fight. Get them here. I'm out of the way, even if... Okay, luckily.
The glimmer of life.
And it is turn five, so it's good. We can do this.
Let's begin.
Take out Sotis.
Good morning.
Now
yes.
Take out the tactics room, and yeah.
Yes, yes.
Okay, at least the second one was. A good clear. First one annoys me. So next time you see Leon, he is going to have Triangle Adept, because that did really annoy me. He should have taken them out. He should not have so much troubles with colorless and blue units. And yeah, it just shows. Leon is probably one of the most heavily overrated units still. He is not great, honestly. He is good in his niche, and even then, in his niche, he can be countered, which just makes it sad. Like, he's so min-maxed towards his niche that when he fails in it, it just makes you feel bad about having used orbs for him. And yeah, that's how I feel. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you come back tomorrow for more, and if you did like, give it a like. Maybe subscribe if you did like it too, for, you know, so that you can see the future videos when I upload them. And I'll see you guys tomorrow then. All right then, take care, bye.